Hey, what's up, you guys? This is JC Penny. Don't let the new audio fool you. This is a recent audio. I made the mistake of having the recording stopping during the gameplay, and I missed this whole scene, so I had to record it for you guys so you can watch it and be up to date with what's going on, because it came in kind of choppy and didn't know where it started or ended. So yeah, so this is what you missed. And it goes into seamlessly into the next part of the video, so I made sure of that. But yeah, so I do apologize about that. There's no commentary in the little I think it's like 5 minutes worth of stuff you've missed, and that's okay because I talk too much. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. I do apologize about that mishap, but we'll go back into the video and you'll be able to hear my crappy audio, which I was using a headset at the time. So yeah, now I have an actual decent mic, so you'll be hearing more of that in my recent videos. But anyway, without further ado, here's the rest of the game, and I do apologize. And yeah, please be kind, subscribe, and thank you so much for watching.
This day has been so messed up. At least I can talk to Rachel now. If I can find her back here. I've already seen what happens when Rachel plays with fire. Rachel plus swords should be fun. Drama teachers always seem so... Sup, Mr. Keaton?
Ah, the birds flee the girl, as do her thoughts. Their presence replaced by madness.
Tell me, young lady, do you still believe true love is a lie?
I don't know. I guess the whole point of love is to leave yourself open to... whatever happens.
Indeed. That is an art many of us attempt and precious few master. Budding dramaturge, may your propitious appearance counteract the tragedy of Stephanie Gingrich's sudden recusal. An emergency, she says.
Word.
Stephanie was our lion of the light board, but platitudinal though it may be, the show must sojourn forth.
That dude is weird.
Did Doug
After
did
all the work Steph did it's amazing that she would drop everything to be there for Mikey. If I know Steph, she must have been super excited to be the lion of the light board tonight. Sucks.
Chloe Price presents Firewalk Laser Light Spectacular!
Hey, Hayden.
Address me as Ferdinand, good lady.
All right. Hey, Ferdinand.
Sup, Chloe. I mean, sup, fair maiden.
Great, method acting.
Really? Thanks.
Hey, Samantha.
Shh.
Nathan, please.
I can't do it, Dad. I'm sorry.
Keep your voice down. Now listen to me.
You don't understand. They all hate me. They're just gonna laugh at me.
Why do you suppose that is?
I don't know.
Because you show weakness. Just like you're doing right now.
But Dad...
When will you learn that this isn't about you and your problems? This is about the Prescott name. My name. You will not embarrass me. Nathan.
Yes.
Good. Now. Break a leg. I'll see you after the show.
Great pep talk, Mr. P. Everyone knows the best way to instill confidence in someone is by intimidating them.
I don't know who you are, but mind your own business.
I'd love to. Don't you have, like, a private bunker filled with gold coins where you could have these conversations?
Nathan.
Fuck!
Hey. Nathan's dad is... some asshole, huh?
I know. I wish he'd just go away and leave him alone.
Nathan's dad sucks. But you should be careful what you wish for when it comes to parents.
Oh, Chloe. I wasn't thinking. I'm sorry.
For what? You didn't kill my dad. Or did you? That was a joke.
I know. Your dark sense of humor reminds me a lot of Nathan's. Actually, the two of you are really similar.
What the hell does that mean?
I'm serious. You're both artistic and surprisingly sensitive. You've been through a lot, and a lot of people unfairly judge you for it. I think you stood up for Nathan yesterday because you know what he's going through. Nathan's hurt and he needs help. But whenever I try to help him, it always seems to make things worse. If you were Nathan right now, what would you want me to do?
When I'm super pissed, the last thing I want is someone trying to calm me down. But maybe it's what I need. Nathan acted like he didn't want our help yesterday. But trust me, he was glad we did.
Wow. Thanks, Chloe. That's actually super helpful.
Bitter much?
I don't get bitter. I get even.
Wonder which Bachelor contestant Victoria stole that line from.
Or did David dig ducks?
See? Another reason to be thankful for my, recent life change. Drew seems to be the captain of every Blackwell sport. Man, I hope he's okay.
Did Doug dig David's garden?
Sports just look so... Exhausting. Looks like Victoria has finally pushed Dana over the... Hey, Dana.
Did Doug dig David's garden? Or did David dig Doug's? Did Doug dig David's garden? Or did David... Did Doug dig David's garden? Or did David dig Doug's?
No way in hell I'm going up on that stage. Rachel?
She's putting something in there. She put something in something.
Whatever that was, it was shady as shit.
It really was.
I need to find whatever Victoria slipped into that drink.
Fuck that. Well, let's just look around.
Even though Steph's not here, her sticky still laid down the law. Hey, kids. Who wants to dress up like Big Bird's fugly cousin? I wouldn't be caught dead in this. Okay, this mask is actually pretty sweet. I hope Rachel gets to wear it. I haven't seen this much spandex since Mom made me go to that Zumba class with her.
I hope, like, I have time to check and, like, Victoria doesn't come in, like, demanding to take the tea right from me or something. That would really suck. So let me just get to the point already. Note.
Adding putting on makeup to the long list of reasons I wouldn't be caught dead on stage.
It's gotta be her bag.
Victoria Chase is actually a pretty talented photographer.
Nathan. Not bad.
Muscle relaxers?
Oh shit.
Hurry now before your tea gets... What are you doing here? This area is for cast and crew only. Or are you only here to try and sabotage the play like you sabotaged my homework? God, you're pathetic.
Here for Rachel, here for me.
I'm here to support Rachel.
How nice.
I want to make sure she's relaxed before the show.
Whatever. Oh, Rachel Amber. It was customary among the thespians of ancient Greece for the understudy to offer hot tea to the lead actress on opening night. As a way of showing appreciation for her tutelage. It is in that spirit that I offer you this beverage. May it help to reveal the essence of your talents for all to see.
Wow. That, thanks. Hold up. Did you hear that?
Hear what? I didn't hear anything.
Oh, I hear it now. It sounds like Mr. Keaton's calling for you.
He is? Oh, he probably wants my thoughts on the set dressing. Okay, don't go anywhere. I'll be right back.
What's going on? Bitch dosed your tea. That is the least surprising thing ever. What should we do?
Switch the cups, let's ask Victoria. Honestly, I would, oh well, wait a minute. I was gonna switch the cups, but They look, they're totally gonna make out. But what if Victoria's using the muscle relaxers and it's not really for Rachel? And if I switch the cups, she actually gets in and gets in deep shit. Let's ask Victoria.
Let's ask Victoria what she thinks.
Oh God, I don't know what that means.
Kind of my style.
I do love your style.
Mr. Keaton's busy with Nathan. I'm sure he'll call in my aesthetic sensibility soon. In the meantime...
Victoria, Chloe says you tried to drug me. That true?
A what? Of course not. A dropout Chloe is clearly directing her misplaced anger at me. I'm sorry your life is a mess, but it's not my fault, okay?
Chloe, Victoria is my friend. She would never do anything to sabotage me.
Then she should prove it. Drink the tea.
I wouldn't dare insult Victoria's integrity.
You're
like
kidding
that.
Right now?
Then again, if that's what it'll take to convince you that Victoria is a good and caring person, fine. Come on, Vic. Put dropout Chloe in her place once and for all.
Why are you stalling then?
Happy?
So happy.
Whatever. If you're done accusing me of things, I'll just be on my way. Bitches.
Wow.
Saved my ass again, Price.
All in a day's work. And this has been a particularly batshit crazy day.
Oh, hey, that's mine. A shirt for a free spirit. I knew you were gonna pick that one.
You can read me like a script, Rachel Amber.
Sweet party, we're ruined. The show is ruined.
That was quick.
My dear young artists, a misfortune most unkind has befallen us. Juliet is waylaid. That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our Ariel. Would that she could but manifest on her master's whim as a true spirit.
I have a weird feeling.
Alas, devoid of an understudy, the situation is a dire one indeed. I'm afraid we may have to cancel. Truly, we are a cursed lot. Even my prodigious imagination cannot conceive of a worse turn of fate. Touché.
Oh my god.
What?
No. Mr. Keaton, no.
Oh no.
Juliet.
No fucking chance.
At least until the road's clear.
The romantic.
She's the right fit for Juliet's costume.
She is indeed. Tell me, my dear, have you ever acted before?
Hell no.
She's being modest. We play improv games all the time. And she's fantastic at it.
My dear, what if I told you that the entire fate of the production rests upon your slender shoulders?
Because it's not resting on Victoria's.
I'd say you're super fucked.
Chloe, please. For me.
Don't give me an option to choose, please. Oh, God.
Damn it.
This is great.
I can't believe Rachel's talked me into this.
Oh, she said I would never be caught wearing this. Oh, my gosh.
I seriously have to memorize all of this?
Fuck.
Thanks, Rachel.
So I bet you, when I'm up there, I'm really gonna have to pick to see if I remember what, you know, my choices. I have to pick my lines. Here's some questions. How much is in here? Holy crap. Alright, so, come away, servant, come. I'm going down there, Miranda falls asleep. Come away, servant, come. I'm ready now. Your cue. Okay, enter Ariel. Ariel. All hail, great mistress. I come to answer thy best pleasure. I'm just going to read Chloe's lines, no longer Ariel's, because I want to memorize it. But I feel like maybe we won't, or maybe we will need to remember. But better to be safe than sorry. Oh, hell, great mistress. Okay. I boarded the king's ship in every cabin. Flamed amazement, the fire and cracks of sulphurous roaring, the most mighty Neptune seemed to besiege and make his bold waves tremble. Not a soul. The king's son, Ferdinand, was the first man that leaped, cried, hell is empty and all the devils are here. It says climb to what? Ariel flies to the shipwreck and points. Not a hair perished, and as though baddest me, I have dispersed them about the isles and troops. Is there more toil? Let me remember thee what thou hast promised. Oh boy, my liberty. That's my noble mistress. Ariel exits. Okay, so let's just hope. Chloe, the show's starting. We got great seats. Where are you? Oh, you'll see. Oh, Frank. I just saw Frank also. Harry, I just talked to Damon. He said he had to come down hard. Didn't see you. What do you mean? What happened? Did you find the money? Price, where's the money? This is serious. Quit fucking around unless you're dead. Reply. Let's meet tomorrow. Have answers. Oh, boy. That's not good. I should just have some of that teal. So, alright, so I'm gonna have to go out. Actually, cruel reflector, hypocrisy times. Let me see if there's any... This is the greatest thing ever. This game is actually really funny. I'm kind of surprised by the humor of it all, because I thought it would be like a bit serious, knowing that this is Chloe and it's her life, but Chloe's hilarious, and you know, I'm sure.
Time for my big debut.
I'm sure that
joy.
They didn't want it to be so depressing, and they wanted it to be lighthearted. Look. yeah, whatever. Oh boy. This is going to be nuts.
By accident, oh my God. No strange, bountiful fortune hath mine enemies brought to the shore. Here, cease more questions. Thou art inclined to sleep. 'Tis a good dullness. And give it way. I know thou canst not choose. Come away, servant. Come.
Ah, shit. I'm on.
That's you.
I am ready now.
Get up there.
Well, let me.
Approach, my Ariel. Come.
Damn it. No problem. I've got this. I just walk to Rachel and say my line.
Hey, I sat here yesterday.
Rachel looks way too pleased with herself for getting me into this.
Okay.
All hail, great mistress. I come to answer thy best pleasure.
Most fearless, generous spirit. Hast thou performed to point the tempest that I bade thee?
I wrote a storm. I forget what I read. Yeah, the pointest temp. He's the I boarded the king's ship. I wrote a storm.
I boarded the king's ship. In every cabin, I flamed amazement. The fire and cracks of sulphurous roaring, the most mighty Neptune seemed to besiege and make his bold waves Tremble!
My brave spirit! Who was so firm, so constant, that this coil would not infect his reason?
Not a soul. The king's son, Ferdinand, was the first man that leaped from his ship and cried. Cried, hell is empty, and all the devils are here.
Yes!
But are they, Ariel? Safe?
Alright. I guess this is when I'm supposed to walk somewhere.
To the shipwreck, right? I'm pretty sure I'm supposed to do this. I went the wrong way.
Not a hair perished. And, as thou badest me, I have dispersed them about the isle.
In troops.
In troops!
Bravo!
Ariel, thy charge exactly is performed.
Perfect.
But there's more work.
Is there?
Is there more toil? Let me remember thee what thou hast promised. How?
What is't thou canst demand?
My liberty.
Indeed.
Thy liberty? Nay, this most of all I will not grant.
That's not her line, is it? What's going on?
But thou assured my freedom, didn't thou?
I never said how dearly I hold thee. My habit's been to keep my soul well draped. Most loyal spirit, companion, and friend. Is acting in my service not replete with excitement, amusement, and delight?
Of course, mistress. Most truly it is so.
Mr. Key, they're way off script. It's magical.
Then why, I pray you, wish you to be free?
Excitement ages quickly. And I fear if we set out in search of new, fun, you'll tire of me, and then I'll be alone.
I have thee in my grasp. I will not bend. I will not see thee flying forth alone. The envy would be more than I could bear.
So come with me. Is that not in thy power?
Spirit, take my hands, most faithful friend, for but a little longer, I beseech. Continue in thy service to my schemes, and when they are complete, I swear to thee, we shall fly beyond this isle. The corners of the world are mere prologue. I'll seek to make thy happiness so great that e'en the name of liberty's forgot. What sayest thou to my most hopeful wish?
Am I signing my soul over to her?
Yes, I am most pleased. Your duty done for now, so go forth hence with haste. I've work to do.
You crushed it. So good.
You're a born thespian, my dear. I'll be chasing you down next year. And the ending, absolutely transformative. I am humbled.
Okay.
What the hell just happened? Was that real?
Of course it was.
Shake it off. Come on. We'll visit Caliban, my slave.
'Tis a villain, sir. I do not love to look on.
He does make our fire, fetch in our wood.
Oh no, Nathan.
Slave!
Don't laugh at him, guys.
Caliban! Come forth, I say!
As wicked do as e'er my mother brush, with raven's feather from unwholesome bed, drop on you both! A southwest blow on ye, and blister you all o'er.
Thou poisonous slave, got by the devil himself, filth as thou art, I have lodged thee in mine own cell, till thou didst seek to violate the honor of my child.
Oh ho, oh ho! Would it had been done! Thou didst prevent me, I had peopled else this isle with Calibans.
Fetch us in fuel, and be quick. So, slave, hence.
He was all right. I mean... awkward.
Where should this music be? In the air or the earth?
This play is super intense.
No shit, I feel like I'm
what
on drugs.
It?
I feel like I'm taking muscle relaxers.
It carries a brave form, but it is a spirit.
No, wench. It eats and sleeps and hath such senses as we have.
I will resist such entertainment.
Put thy sword up, traitor!
Do you love me?
O heaven, O earth, bear witness to this sound. I, beyond all limit of what else in the world, do love, prize, honor you.
His tears run down his beard, like winter's drops from eaves of reeds.
Go release them, Ariel. My charms I'll break. Their senses I'll restore, and they shall be themselves. Now my charms are all overthrown. And what strength I have's mine own. Pray, release me from my bands, with the help of your good hands.
Good job, you guys, good job. There's like 12 people there. Okay, there's a good amount. No, you guys are too kind. Thank you, thank you. No. I would be embarrassed to do that too. Oh, of course she is.
Wasn't that fun?
You're so dead.
Yeah? How dead?
Hella dead.
Meanwhile, Victoria is like really feeling those muscle relaxers right now. Good. Why was she watching? Something is so fishy about that. She kind of reminds me of, like, Rachel in a way. Huh. I'm looking outside. I think I see a family member outside shoveling snow.
Oh my god! Keaton's face behind you when you walked on stage? I was shitting myself.
In the dead old night, I'll meet you in my sleep.
He was shitting himself. That dude owes me.
Sorry, Elliot. Clearly I didn't hang out with you afterwards.
Like a dream come true, I'll take you where I roam. And
my dear, what if I told you that
the entire fate of our production rests upon your slender shoulders. I've never had an experience like that on stage. Yeah, right? You were...
No, you. Like, seriously. I love nights after a show.
Is it always like this?
Oh, totally. It's such a high. No more nerves, just the adrenaline. So, first timer, are you proud of yourself? You were literally perfect tonight. I was blown away.
I think I'm just happy it's over. The last 12 hours have been freaking intense.
You've gone through so much shit today.
Right now's pretty good. Okay, the whole show was good. I admit it.
Yeah. It was magical.
Cute. Aww. I love it.
Let's leave. For real.
For real, huh?
You said you wanted to skip town and never look back. Like I said last night, let's do it.
I know. I've been thinking about that all day.
But that was... Don't say it was just a crazy thought. You mean it. I can tell. You want this.
Yeah, but, like, eventually.
Let's go now. Didn't we already agree on stage?
We can't.
You're high,
just...
dude.
Why not?
What about money?
I thought you were a high-rolling criminal now.
I collected the money Frank wanted, but then I gave it back to Drew instead.
It sounded like he needs it more.
No shit! But man, I'm not looking forward to what Frank has to say when he finds out.
We'll figure it out, Chloe. Anyway, I've got more than enough to start us out. I always get birthday money from my dad. Or should I say, hush money. Any more questions?
How far could we possibly get without a car?
I thought you were fixing that truck in the junkyard.
I was just seeing if I could.
Well, can you or can't you?
Yeah, I can.
That's hot. In other words, we've got transportation covered.
I know our parents have been shitty, but we can't just leave them.
That doesn't sound like Chloe Price.
Wouldn't it hurt your mom? She doesn't deserve that, right?
I don't deserve to live in the middle of my parents' mistakes.
Right. Of course you don't. Fine then, drama queen. Where are we going?
You tell me. What uniquely twisted location does Chloe Price plus Rachel Amber equal?
Hell. New York City.
Obviously. 3 a.m. You and me outside some cafe on St. Mark's, shoving pizza in our mouths and shouting Broadway songs with 10 people we just met. And this cute guy in horn-rimmed glasses will pass by and see you and slow down.
Yeah. Okay.
He'll be like, "Want to split a cab?" And I'll be like, "Back off. She's with me."
You're full of shit.
I love this time of night.
What the fuck did the whole New York thing mean?
Don't you just feel like everything's possible?
Rachel, stop. If you don't mean this, it's just making me feel like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen.
For fuck's sake! I've never been more serious in my life. Chloe, what would it take to convince you?
I'm going with a kiss. I don't want her bracelet. That's hers. A tattoo of what? Oh, God.
How about,
Oh.
Oh my God, is it really gonna happen? Chloe, Rachel, awesome.
Is that convincing enough?
Yeah.
This is so exciting. I'm like so happy that this is going on right now. And cheesing like a
Holy
fucking
shit.
Loser.
Right?
I hope she's not fucking with me.
What is this stuff?
Ash?
I think it's a sign. I think we should leave tonight.
Really?
If you want to, I'm ready. Let's go sneak some clothes and stuff for my house.
For you or for me?
I gotta say, my clothes look damn good on you.
Cool. Let's do it.
And then we'll get the hell out of Arcadia Bay.
That sounds perfect.
Oh God, this is gonna be creepy. Integrity, honesty, and loyalty, all of which you do not have, sir. Yeah, my family member that was outside shoveling kind of quit because the snow was just keeps falling. I wish I was in Arcadia Bay right now. Is that snow or what? Like, oh man, I can't believe we just saw that. Like, that is awesome. That wouldn't have happened if I didn't. Unless maybe she would have kissed me anyway. Felt kind of embarrassed asking, but fuck it. I got my kiss, right? let me know, you guys, like, what did you choose? And if you didn't play the game and you're just following my playthrough, just let me know what you thought of my decision and what you would have chosen. This is awkward.
Oh, you're home.